हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम नेहा पाटिल। वेलकम यू ऑल टू माय चैनल डेटा स्ट्रक्चर कॉन्सेप्ट्स। हियर यू विल लर्न ऑल द बेसिक कॉन्सेप्ट्स ऑफ डेटा स्ट्रक्चर्स। फॉर मोर इन्फॉर्मेशन विजिट माय चैनल एंड डोंट फॉरगेट टू सब्सक्राइब इट टू गेट अपडेट्स ऑफ लेटेस्ट वीडियोज। टुडे वी विल सी द नेक्स्ट एक्सप्रेशन कन्वर्जन, दैट इज द पोस्टफिक्स टू प्रीफिक्स एक्सप्रेशन कन्वर्जन। In the previous videos, we have seen the infix to postfix, infix to prefix, postfix to infix, and now we will see the postfix to prefix conversion. So this is again the same technique like the postfix to infix conversion, but here only whatever the output is there that we want in the prefix format. So our operator should be at the first position and then our operand should be there. So like this way we have to make the combination. In case of the infix, we are writing like the a plus b. That means operator is in between the operands here, but in case of the prefix format, our operator should be at the first position and then our operand should be there. So by considering this format, now we have to convert this postfix expression to the prefix format. So I will explain you now how to convert it. Again, as it is the postfix expression, so again we have to scan it from the left to right. We have to scan the one by one character. And if it is the operand, again we have to push it onto the stack. And whenever the operator is coming, topmost two operands we have to delete from the stack. We have to make the combination in the prefix format, and then that final expression again we have to push it onto the stack. So this procedure we have to repeat till the expression gets over, and final expression we will see onto the stack. That we have to delete and print, we will get the final prefix expression. So we will solve this, then you will understood it. So now the first character is the A, that means the operand is there, so push it onto the stack. So stack will look like this way. Next character is the B, again the operand is there, so again push it onto the stack. Next character is the C, that means operand is there, again push it onto the stack. Now the multiplication operator is coming. So whenever the operator is coming, topmost two operands we have to delete from the stack. That means this C and B we have to delete from the stack. Our operator is the multiplication. So as we are going to convert it to the prefix format, so operator should be at the first position. That means this multiplication should be at the first position. Then what we have to do here, this C and B we have to append at the end of this multiplication. So it should look like the B and the C. It should not look like the CB. So that means the first deleted will go to the last position and the second deleted will go to the middle position. So it will look like the into BC. It should not look like the into CB. So this care always you have to take there. And this into BC again we have to push onto the stack. So our now the stack will look like this way. The A will be as it is. And this into BC will be the next operand onto the stack. Now the next character, if you see, again the operator is there. That means the plus operator is there. So whenever the plus operator is coming, again the topmost two operands we have to delete from the stack. That means we will delete this into BC and the A, and our operator is the plus. So plus will become the first position. Then our A will come. And then our this into BC will come. So the prefix expression will look like this way. Plus A into BC. Plus is the operator. A is one operand. Into BC is the another operand is there. So this whole now we have to again push onto the stack. So now the stack will look like this way. Plus A into BC. So this is the expression onto the stack. Next, if you see, the operand X is there, push it onto the stack. Next character is the Y, operand is there, push it onto the stack. Next character is the Z, operand is there, push it onto the stack. And now the next character is the division operator is there. So whenever the division operator is coming, then these topmost two operands we have to delete from the stack. Along with this division operator, we have to form the prefix expression like this way. Division, Y and the Z. So this will become the prefix format. This prefix expression now again we have to push onto the stack. So stack will look like this way. this plus a into bc will be as it is, this x will be as it is, and now the prefix expression is the slash yz. So the stack will look like this way. Next, if you see, the plus operator is there. So whenever the plus operator is coming, now these topmost two operands we have to delete from the stack. Along with this plus operator, the combination will look like this: plus x slash y and the z. That means plus is the scanned operator, this x is the deleted operand is there, and the slash yz is the another deleted operand is there. So this prefix expression again we have to push onto the stack. So now our stack will look like this way: this plus a into bc as it is, and now the second is what? The plus x slash yz. Plus x slash yz. So this is our the stack is there. Next is the last character is the division operator is there. So again, whenever the division operator is coming, this division, this topmost two we have to delete. So this, along with this division operator, we have to form the combination like, it will look like this: plus a into bc will become the first operand, plus x slash yz will become the second operand, and this expression again we have to push onto the stack. So our stack will look like this way. It will contain this expression, and as the expression is over, this is our the final result which is present onto the stack. So now what we have to do, this result we have to delete from the stack and we have to print, and we will get our the final prefix expression like slash plus a into bc plus x slash yz. So if you see here, the operators are at the first position and then the operands are there. So this is called like the prefix format is there, and this is our the final prefix expression is there. So in this way we have to convert the postfix to prefix conversion. What we have done here, we have scanned the expression from the left to right. Whenever the operands are coming, we are pushing it onto the stack. Whenever the operator is coming, along with the operator and whatever the deleted operands are there, we are making the prefix expression. That prefix expression again we are pushing onto the stack, and this process we have to repeat till the expression gets over. Whenever our expression will get over, final result will be present onto the stack. That we have to delete and we have to print, so we will get our the final prefix expression. So hope by this example you have understood the concept of the postfix to prefix conversion. So thank you for watching this video.